Looking ahead to the trading week beginning December 20th, we'll start as always by looking back at the equity performance over the last week. And all four indices were down, with the NASDAQ being the best performer, the lowest drop for the week. NASDAQ would be the worst performer, with the S&P and the Russell right in between there. But now the Russell is down 5 of the last 6 weeks, the NASDAQ 3 of the last 4 weeks, the S&P 3 of the last 4 weeks, and the Dow down 5 of the last 6 weeks as well, just like the Russell. Pretty bad performance for the equities last week as we come into a shortened week that typically has low liquidity. We may get some dramatic price movements in all assets the next 2 weeks. Historically, typically, you see less liquidity, less interest in the markets overall. But that low interest could also mean that there's not many moves at all. So you want to watch for those low liquidity situations that tend to happen as we're coming into holidays. Now, we also have commodity prices, rates, and the dollar that you need to pay attention to. Crude was down, but not by much on a weekly basis. Copper recovered over 4% to finish near unchanged. And both gold and silver had their first positive weeks in the last 5. The dollar's now up 7 of the last 8 weeks. And this week was the strongest rally in the US dollar since November 15th, in part because of weakness in the euro, while rates fell on Friday, late Thursday, early Friday, and all day Friday, I should say. Interest rates in the US fell, with the 2-year getting down to 162. We had the 10-year down around 138 from 144. Previously, it had been in the 150s and then the 170s even before that, on a high level in that 10-year. So rates falling, the dollar getting stronger. It's important to look at where the trajectory of these three key things are: commodity prices, rates, and the dollar, to see if it's having any effect in toward the end of the year, especially in terms of the economic outlook. Now, in terms of data, we do have data on Monday, U.S. Conference Board's leading economic index for November. Tuesday, we get German January consumer confidence data, UK public net sector borrowing, and out of Canada, we get month over month retail sales for November and year over year new housing prices. In the euro area, we get consumer confidence flash reading for December. And then that evening, we get the Bank of Japan's monetary policy meeting minutes for that prior meeting we just had on Friday morning. On Wednesday in the UK, we get final quarter over quarter and year over year GDP growth for the third quarter. Then we get the same data in the US, plus final quarter over quarter PCE price data and November existing home sales. That night in the UK, we get GFK consumer confidence data for December. Then on Thursday, big data dump. We get final coincident and leading economic indexes for October in Japan, month over month GDP for October in Canada. Then in the US, weekly jobless claims, more PCE price data in the form of the more watched month over month and year over year figures for November, along with durable goods, personal spending, and final December Michigan consumer sentiment and inflation data. Then that evening in Japan, we get their November inflation data. Friday, we're closed for the Christmas holiday. Happy holidays to everyone. Have fun with your family celebrating whatever it is you celebrate.